Okay, this is a brother Mitch reporting from Del Pilar Street. This is a Del Pilar Street in the Ermita area over in Old Manila. And I'm going to tell you a story about something that happened to me in 1993 right in this area. Now, I'm not always going to look at the camera because I'm also addressing our School of Evangelism 2008 graduates and some friends, and my children are here today because this is a testimony of God's greatness and what God can do in and through our lives. But the story starts in 1993. My wife and I had about 10 weeks of free time, so we pray for these bars because almost every building back then in 93 was a bar. There's still some bars here, but I'm going to point out one a little later. But this was bars, prostitutes. There was at least 300 prostitutes just in this stretch right here. So we would worship and then pray. We'd pray for Mayor Lim. He was the mayor during that time. We'd pray, Lord, close these bars. We'd pray for the police station back here. We'd pray for the vendors. And then we'd start preaching. We'd preach right on this sidewalk. And my friend Robert, the black guy, had a sound system he'd bring with him, strapped it over his shoulder. Big shoulders, big strong guy. And we'd face particularly this bar here across the street where you see the Coca-Cola bottle. And we'd really preach, you know. We'd say things like, don't go in this bar, there's many demons inside. And so the people would come out of these bars and listen to us preaching. On week number three, the owner of that bar across the street, which used to be called Misty's Bar, which it says now Zuri Inn, which is now a Coca-Cola a bottle bodega or storage facility, distribution storage of empty bottles. But the owner of that bar attacked me on Friday number three, week number three. He choked me and threw me into the street. My Bible flew into the air. I picked up my Bible and I kept preaching because there was many people in front of all these different bars listening. But I only preached for about 30 more seconds or 1 minute because he pushed my throat so much he damaged my vocal cords. So we went home early that night. But we kept coming out. We kept week number four, week number five, six, seven, eight. And then on the ninth Friday, I didn't come out here because my wife received her visa, Liberty, and we were able to go back to America for 2 years. So I didn't come out on week number nine. But the rest of the team came out anyhow. And then on Saturday morning, I asked them, how did it go? What did you experience? And they said, Mitch, guess what? And I said, what? And they said, we went out there like normal, and the bars were all closed. They said, Mayor Lim, the mayor of Manila back in 93, he closed all the bars, boarded them shut, you know? Well, I thought it was hard to believe. So I came out on week number 10, right before we basically left the country, to see for myself. And sure enough, back then all of these bars were closed down. There was wood across the door, wood across the windows, and there was like nobody here. It was like ghost town, you know? Well, I don't know, maybe 9 years later, 7 years later, I was talking to a YWAM leader from Angeles City. And he said, Mitch, guess what? I met the owner of that bar that you said attacked you. He went to Angeles, opened up another bar, went bankrupt, opened up a third bar, that went bankrupt, and he's had visa problems, passport problems. His live-in, not his wife, but his live-in left him, and he started losing weight from all of his problems. And so the YWAM leader in Angeles City, that's 3 hours from here approximately, said, I met the owner that attacked you, and he's having all kinds of problems. And he has actually come to the YWAM Center twice now to talk with me. And I've counseled him and I've even prayed for him once. And he told me, Mark Weir was his name. He says, he has not become a Christian yet. But I've met him, Mitch. It's amazing. Well, a few years after that, I was teaching in a YWAM school in Baguio City, a discipleship training school. And I was sharing the same story. And a girl in the back of the row said, Brother Mitch. I used to work at that bar in Angeles City. the fourth bar that he has owned. Matter of fact, she was working in the bar as a bar girl, which is like a prostitute. Somebody was walking past the bar passing out literature. She received one, gave her life to Jesus, and they encouraged her to do a YWAM DTS, Discipleship Training School. So she left the bar, joined YWAM training, became a disciple. I don't know where she is now, but she says, I know that owner, I know him. He's the Misty's bar owner in Angela City. Well, this bar used to be called Misty's. And I'll tell you, Misty's bar, now Zuri Inn, now a Coca-Cola storage facility, you know, was definitely the focus of all of our preaching, all of our noise, all of our rebuking for 9 weeks solid. Well, the year is now 2008. What's that? 2008 minus 1993. That's 15 years ago, isn't it? So 15 years ago, God closed down many of these bars through Mayor Lim. Now, some of them have reopened, but many of them are just restaurants now, and particular like this one, Osera, this is a restaurant now. It's no longer a bar 15 years later, but Misty's, hallelujah. Misty's bar, 15 years later, is a Coca-Cola garage. It's like a storage facility for empty Coke bottles. And I just praise God for that because, well, I guess rule number one, never attack a preacher. Yeah, you attack a preacher, God's gonna close your business, amen. And rule number two, if we're faithful in the small things, doing what we do best, God's gonna bring the breakthrough. Can you say amen? Now, I know not everybody can preach in front of a bar, but everybody in the body of Christ, those of you watching, and of course, whatever you guys end up doing, all of us do something for Jesus, don't we? All of us should be doing something for Jesus. And whatever we do for Jesus, we should do it with all of our heart and to not be weary in well-doing, for in due season, in the right time, if we don't faint, God will bring the increase. Be not weary in well-doing, for in due season, God will bring the increase. So praise God. If we're faithful in the small things, God will trust us with big things. And God will bring the breakthrough. And you know, when all this happened, we were like surprised. But we remembered, yeah, we prayed that God would close those bars down. We prayed for Mayor Lim. We prayed for that God would touch the owners, that God would touch the managers, that God would touch the bar girls. And he did. Like we were surprised when it happened. Well, I learned not to be surprised anymore when God does these things after we pray. But it doesn't just happen overnight. And it doesn't just happen breakthrough in 9 weeks. It might take 9 years. Or 19 years. Or 90 years. Grabe. Grabe means stand. So let this be a lesson. This is like a monument of God's faithfulness in my life as a preacher, and how he has, you know, reestablished this, the basic teaching of, if we're faithful to God, especially in the small things, doing what we do best, God's going to bring the breakthrough eventually, somehow, some way, if we trust in him. So whoever you are out there, be faithful to God, and God will bring breakthrough in your life. This is Brother Mitch signing off. April 12th. School of Evangelism number 6 in the Philippines. God bless you.